So f of q equals a, then q, q double prime is q plus q a over y, y squared is the distance, and then q, k is there, and q, and then q prime is minus q a over y, y minus y prime is a square over y, and then whole squared. And further, I will have to write here that this is in the direction of y. So y vector by y means y unit vector. This force is in the direction of y. Now I can simplify this one. If we look here, then q over y square, if I take this one as common, then q over y square will come here. What about here? From here I will take y as common, so it will become y square. This will become 1 minus a square over y square, whole square. And then q over y square I can take common. So this thing is equal to k q over y square, and then this will be, I can write this, what it will be, if q over y square is gone out of here, then this is q plus q over ay. So if I write q separate, then plus q over q a over y plus, and then this whole term which is actually remaining is minus, q over y square are gone, so q a over y divided by, this will be 1 minus a square over y square whole square, and y over y, right? Clear? Because I have taken q over y square common, so this q is no more here, and minus and plus is minus, and q a over y here, and then here when you take y as common, then this is 1 minus a square over y square whole square. Now if you see here, then this term q a over y here and q a over y here are common as well. So I can further write this thing, that this is equal to k q over y square, and this one is q, and if I write this one is minus, because I want to give it a shape, and q a over y, so that I can put the limiting conditions here, a minus a over y q, then this will be written as 2 minus a square over y square and whole divided by 1 minus a square over y square whole square and y over y. Now think of this thing. How I got this step? Look here. This is taken as LCM of it. So 1 minus a square y square. So with q a over y, you are having this is multiple. Right? You can do this step yourself. Make this one, then minus q a over y will come, and whole divided by this one. Now when this one is multiplied with it, so I'm writing, instead of this means this term will become 2 here, so I have taken 2 here, and the rest 1 minus a square y is coming here, but with this one, 1 here and 1 here, this one becomes 2, and you can take that one common from here. So do this step yourself. This is easy. Just take this LCM, multiply with this, minus this, then take q a over y, q is common, so a over y, and take a over y cube here. If you remultiply this thing, you will get back this result. Now this is just for the purpose of putting the limits, because we are having two limits. One is the short distance, one is the short distance limit. Short distance limit is what? When y is approximately a, and the long distance limit is that y is very, very greater than a. Now look here, when in this situation, you remember the previous one, when y was very, very greater than a, then it was the force was varying as 1 over y cube. Now let's check that situation here. Look here, when y will be very, very greater than a, means the long distances, then this term will go to 0, so all the denominator is becoming 1, right? Okay. How much it is varying then? Your denominator is going to 1. Look here now. That if I forget this portion, what is that force remaining? Purely Coulombic force, right? Because this is kqq by y square. The only difference which is occurring is in this portion. When y is very, very greater than a, then the denominator is going to 1. So forget about the denominator. Look here. What will happen here? The same situation. This one will go to 0. Right? So this is 2 minus this. So no problem with this one. Look here. How this term is changing. Means this is subtracted from it. And this term is becoming very, very small. So it means all this term is going to 0. And we are having again the 1 over y square variation. So what does it mean? Earlier this was varying as 1 over y cube. And now this is varying as 1 over y square. So the Coulomb law or the attractive force is remaining is 1 over y square, the typical one. So F is then 1 over y square. Now if it would be, if the earlier case it was a grounded conducting sphere, you were moving the charge away, so the force was decreasing. And it was becoming 1 over y cube. Now here in this situation, some additional charge is there. And that additional charge, you are going away from it. But the additional charge is compensating the deficiency of your moment. And that's why it is coming out to be q with q square. And it is attractive or repulsive? Because the force is coming out to be positive. This Q we have considered as a positive charge, not negative. So the force is coming out to be repulsive overall. Why? Because you are moving away from it, and your movement is actually causing this one to decrease, q prime. So the only charge remaining is q double prime, which is positive, which is equal to q plus q a over y. So this one, the force is repulsive between the two. Clear? This is the same situation as you experience between two atoms. You know the potential of two atoms, how it is. If this is R and this is potential, then it is something like this. Why it's like this? Because you are having a positive core here, an electron is going around it, and then another positive core, an electron is going around here. When you are decreasing the distance between the two, your potential is becoming more and more negative. More and more negative potential means this is now the force of attraction between the two. So how this force of attraction works? This positive core is attracting this one, and this positive is attracting that negative charge. There is a repulsive force between the two electrons. There is a repulsive force between the two protons. But at this much distance, these two are not countable here, but the attractive one is dominant here. So as you are becoming closer, closer and closer, at this point you are having the distance equal or not, which you call the equilibrium distance. It's a certain distance between these two atoms. They feel attraction to each other. When they reach at that point and you are further getting them close, then what happens? This one and this one is also contributing, but actually these two starts to repel each other, and the core force is, you can say, more. This force and this one, they both contribute more than the attractive, means the particles are there. When they are closer than this one, this range, then the electron is attracted by this one. The electron is attracted by this one as well, but now the repulsive force is becoming more in magnitude. And what happens? Your potential is becoming less and less negative, means some less and less negative, not repulsive, but less and less negative magnitude. And when you reach exactly this distance, because this is not a straight line like this vertical line, this is somehow a little bit, you can say, from this point which is going straight to that point, it is somehow like this. So that distance matters a lot, and your potential becomes positive at this point, and now they are repelling each other. There is no more attraction. The same situation is here as well, that you are having a core electron, there is attractive force, there is a repulsive force first, because we considered the situation in which y is very, very greater than a. Now if I consider the short distance that y is approximately a, then what happens here? Forget about this side, but look at this side, this component. A over y will become approximately 1 here. What about approximately become 1? So it is 2 minus 1, so 1. This is only minus q. What about here? We will have to expand this one now, because we cannot make this 1, and otherwise it will blow. So what will happen? This will become 1 minus 2 a square over y square, 2 a square over y square, this portion. And now when this one, 1 minus means 1 minus you are having here, this is q times all this is 1, and now this will go up, like this goes up and it becomes positive, because this is minus 2 there and it will become 1 plus there. So what's going on here, that you are having the situation that Q minus Q, and this is 1 plus 2 A square over Y square, something like this approximately. Now look here, minus Q times this, two terms are there. Minus Q is there, so from this Q you are subtracting minus Q. Q minus, this is minus Q minus 2Q A square over Y square. So we will now check, that whether the minus is getting more than the plus, whether this Q minus this one is going to be zero, or this one, this magnitude is more than this one. Look at the value of Q. Look at the value of Q. Q is actually, means Q double prime, which is the charge there, is Q minus Q prime. What is Q prime? This is Q A over Y. So this is the total charge. This is the, let me say it like this. The total charge Q is the summation of Q in Q double prime. What is Q prime? Q prime is this one, means Q times A over Y. So I can write this one is Q minus Q minus 2 Q A over Y and A over Y. Can I write like this?
Yes.
So what does this mean? That this is actually Q prime. Q minus Q minus 2 and Q prime A over Y. Q prime is also subtracted from this, minus 2 times Q prime is subtracted from this one. And minus Q is also subtracted from this one. So it means that this magnitude comes less than this magnitude, and as a result our force becomes, means force is proportional to Q over Y square, force is proportional to 1 over Y square, but it is coming out to be negative, it is coming out to be attractive. You are closer to the sphere, you feel attraction. You are going away from the sphere, you feel repulsion. Clear?
Yes.
Which is not the situation like this one. Why? The situation is opposite to this one. The reason is that here are two positive charges and two negative charges, while the situation that we are having is actually this one, that we are having one positive charge, one negative charge, which is the induced charge Q prime, and one positive charge here. So if you are now moving this one there, if it will be closer, then it will be feeling this electron attractive force. But when it will be away, only these two will interact. The electron will not contribute that much. So you are closer to such a sphere, the force is attractive, and you are away from such a sphere, the force is repulsive. Because the reason
this,
is
yes, that's why we have to apply the force to change into molecule atoms. Because the population
is being, let me say this thing again. This is Q. when this will go closer to it, this is time is induced there. Clear? When this will be away, then there is no Q prime there. Charge is not induced there. And it experiences only Q double prime. That's why force is repulsive. When it comes closer, it induces Q prime and there is attraction. Clear? Yes, that will be your question.
In this case, when two atoms change into a molecule, that's why we have to apply the force. Because when they come closer to each other, the force of the repulsion increases. Then two of this force of repulsion and change into molecule.
Yes, there will, there should be some external agent which make this atom or these atoms into a molecule. And that's the reason they will have to lose some energy, which is the binding energy in the molecule. The same is true for, you can say, inside an atom, for two protons as well. You will have to fuse them. They will have to release some energy. Now suppose that the potential on the sphere is having some fixed value, because we have written just phi non-zero. Now non-zero can be any value. Let's say I fix this potential to a value such that this phi is now equal to V, capital V. Now this is a fixed potential. So for phi equals V, we have now specified that potential there. And what this will cause? This will cause us to specify the value of charge as well there. That charge will be such that it will cause this much potential on the surface. So for this potential, this means that we will have to select the value of Q double prime such that to have phi equals V on the surface. We will have to select the value of phi, the value of Q double prime such that it will be equal to this. So the term that potential V will be equal to K Q double prime over A. Why I am taking A? Because Q double prime is principally on the surface. So this is the potential on the surface, and from here I can write that K Q double prime is equals A times V. So I can write the potential phi of x is equal to K Q over x minus y plus K Q y over a and x minus a squared over y squared y and plus a b over x. Because for k q double prime over x, I am writing now, for k q double prime is a b n over x. So this will be the potential. And what will happen to the force? The force f q will be equal to, the force will come out to be equal for k q double prime. Now you will have to write a b. So I am writing, this is Q AB over Y squared, because over there is Y squared. This is KQ Q prime. So for KQ double prime, for KQ double prime, I have written AB. And then Q over Y squared minus k, the rest will be the same. If I just, you can say, combine these two terms. So I will have k cubed squared a over y divided by y minus a squared over y whole square, and this whole is in y over y.